Hello everyone, trust you're doing good. In this very video, we are going to start a series on trigonometric ratios or trigonometric relationships, okay? So, first of all, you should know that a trigonometric ratio, or will I say trigonometry, is the relationship between the sides of a triangle and the angles of a triangle. So we are going to start with trigonometric ratios here. There are six trigonometric ratios. We have sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. Now, these six trigonometric ratios are abbreviated as sine, S-I-N, cos, tangent is T-A-N, cosec, C-S-C, sec, S-E-C, then cot, okay? Now, these are referred to as ratios since they can be expressed in terms of a side of a triangle, right angle triangle for a specific angle, okay? So, look at our right angle triangle here. Now remember that the side facing the angle is called the opposite. The longest side is called the hypotenuse. Then while the other side, the remaining side, is called the adjacent. Okay. So trigonometric ratios, sine theta is actually opposite of adjacent. Now we use the so katua to remember the first three. So katua. Okay. T O A. Okay. So your sine is opposite of hypotenuse. Your cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and your tangent is opposite over adjacent, okay? So that's what we have here. Your cos is adjacent over hypotenuse, and your tangent is opposite over adjacent. Now, but notice that tangent is sine over cos. So, remember we say that sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse, okay? And we also say that cos theta is adjacent over hypotenuse, okay? So if we divide sine theta by cos theta, that's sine theta divided by cos theta, we are going to get opposite over hypotenuse divided by adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay? So that is now going to give us opposite over hypotenuse, okay, times hypotenuse over adjacent, okay? So you can see here the hypotenuse cancels hypotenuse, so we are left to just opposite over adjacent, okay? And what is opposite over adjacent? Tan. So what that means is that anywhere we see tan theta is the same thing as saying sine theta over cos theta. Or whenever we see sine theta over cos theta, we know it is tan theta. Please don't forget this. Now you should also know that the cosec is actually reciprocal of sine, okay? It's reciprocal of sine. So if sine theta is opposite over hypotenuse, that means cosec will be hypotenuse over opposite. The same thing with sec. Sec is reciprocal of cos. If cos is adjacent over hypotenuse, it means that sec is hypotenuse over adjacent. The same thing with cot. Cot is 1 over tan theta, which means cos theta over sine theta. Please don't forget that. Okay, so that leads us to trigonometric identities. Okay, now first of all, we see that according to the Pythagoras theorem, and if you have your Pythagoras theorem, let's say this is the angle theta here. This is A, which means opposite. This is B, which is adjacent. C is the longest side, which is hypotenuse. Okay, so according to Pythagoras theorem, we know that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared, or you can say A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared, like we have here. Now let's see, we want to derive certain things here. If we divide through by C squared, you know, let's say you have A squared plus B squared equal to C squared. Dividing through by C squared, I will get over C squared over C squared, okay? So A squared over C squared means A over C all squared, plus B squared over C squared means B over C all squared. Then C squared over C squared is 1. Now, if you look at the diagram, you see that your A is opposite, and your C is hypotenuse. The opposite of hypotenuse, that's sine. So A over C means sine. So that means I have sine theta all squared. Plus B over C is adjacent over hypotenuse. That's cos. So I have cos theta all squared. Okay. All equal to 1. Now another way we can write this actually is that sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is equal to 1. That's exactly what we have here. That's the first trigonometric, you know, identity. The sine square of an angle plus the cos square of an angle is equal to 1. You can try with your calculator. If you have your calculator, try sine 13 all squared plus, okay, sorry. Okay, if you use your calculator, try sine squared maybe 30 degrees plus cos squared 30 degrees. You're going to see what you get. It's going to be equal to 1. Now, but of course, if you are pressing with your calculator, you can't press it this way. You know, with your calculator, you open bracket, you write sine 30, close the bracket, squared, plus you open bracket, write cos 30, close the bracket, then squared, you know, and you press equal sign, it's going to be equal to 1. So from here, we can see that sine squared of an angle, okay, plus cos squared of an angle is equal to 1. That is undisputed. Now let's go back to that. You see, we remember we say a squared plus b squared equal to c squared. We got the first identity by dividing through by c squared, but now we want to divide through by a squared. So if we do that, this divided by a squared, divided by a squared, divided by a squared. Okay, so this is going to be 1 plus this is b over a, okay, equal to b over a all squared equal to this is c over a all squared. Okay, so this is 1 plus, remember that b over a means adjacent over opposite. Okay, adjacent over opposite is the reciprocal of tan, that's cot. So this is cot theta. Okay, so this is going to be cot theta squared. Okay, then equal to c over a means hypotenuse over opposite, and hypotenuse over opposite is the reciprocal of sine, that's cosec. Okay, so you have c s c theta cosec theta all squared, okay, which you can still write as 1 plus cos squared theta is equal to cosec squared theta. So this is another identity, is something that you should always remember, that 1 plus cos squared theta is equal to cosec squared theta. Note that. So let's see another one again. Remember, we have a squared plus b squared equal to c squared. This time around, if we decide to divide through by b squared, this will be a squared over b squared, this will be b squared over b squared, this will be c squared over b squared. Now a squared over b squared means a over b all squared, okay, plus b squared over b squared is 1, then c squared over b squared is c over b all squared. Remember that a over b is tan, so this is going to be tan theta. So I'm going to get tan theta squared, okay, plus 1 equal to c over b. A over b means opposite over adjacent, so which is tan. C over b is hypotenuse over adjacent, okay, that's the reciprocal of cos, and reciprocal of cos is sec. So you have sec theta, okay, all squared, which we can still write as tan squared theta plus 1 is equal to sec squared theta. That is another identity, so which you must remember. So in summary, what are the identities we must remember in this first case? We have sine squared theta plus cos squared theta must be equal to 1. That's the first one, is a constant, is an identity. We have 1 plus cos squared theta is equal to cosec square theta, that's another identity. Then we have 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. Okay, never forget this, because this identity, for you to do well in trigonometry, you must be embraced with identities. Okay, so that leads us to the next thing. Let's see a question here. We asked to show that 1 minus sine a all over 1 plus sine a is equal to sec a minus tan a all squared. Now, first of all, when you have 1 minus sine a all over 1 plus sine a, this is a, okay. Sorry, let's clean that up. Let's write it again. 1 minus sine a, then all over 1 plus sine a. The best way to break down something like this is to multiply through by the conjugate of the denominator. Whenever you see a question like this, especially trigonometry, you just multiply through by the conjugate of the denominator. So that means I can say times 1 minus sine a. The denominator is 1 plus sine a, so the conjugate means the plus becomes minus. So all over 1 minus sine a. Now, if you open the brackets, 1 times 1 gives us 1. 1 times sine a is sine a minus sine a. Minus sine a times 1 minus sine a. The minus sine a times minus sine a will give us plus sine squared a. We are getting somewhere. Now, divided by 1 plus sine a times 1 minus sine a will give us difference of 2 squares, you know. That means it's going to give us 1 squared minus sine squared a. You know, remember, difference of 2 squares, when you say a minus b and a plus b, is the same thing as saying a squared minus b squared. Okay? So, this is exactly what we have. So, let me erase some parts here. Wow, this is wonderful. Okay. Now we continue from there. So the denominator now becomes 1 minus sine a minus sine a is 2 sine a. Okay, then plus sine squared a. Okay, everything all over here. The denominator here is 1 minus sine squared a. And 1 minus sine squared a is cos squared a according to the identity. Remember, when you say sine squared a plus cos squared a equal to 1, it means that cos squared a will be 1 minus sine squared a. Okay, so this is exactly what we have. So, how do we simplify this? So, we can go ahead to say, let me rub off this so that we can continue from there. Okay. Oh, good. So now, since everything here is all over cos squared a, we can have 1 over cos squared a, okay, to break it down, minus 2 sine a all over cos squared a, then plus sine squared a all over cos squared a. Okay, 1 over cos squared a is actually sec squared a because the reciprocal of cos is sec, okay? Then minus, remember that sine a over cos a, okay, let's write it this way, 2 sine a, okay, all over cos a, okay, is okay. Cos squared a means cos a times cos a. Then plus sine squared a here over cos squared a here will give us tan squared a. Okay, so we can now continue with saying this is sec squared a minus, now you know reciprocal of cos a is going to give us 2, 1 over cos a is sec a, okay, then sine a over cos a is tan a, okay, now plus tan squared a, so you have tan squared a. This is beautiful. So let's see, let me rewrite that again. So now we have sec squared a minus 2 sec a tan a, okay, plus tan squared a. Now amazingly, this is looking like a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, and this is the same thing as saying a minus b all squared. So it means that the whole of this now is the same thing as saying sec a minus tan a all squared, which is exactly what we are looking for. So we have been able to confirm that the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So let's move to another question. Here we are asked to show that tan 4 theta plus tan squared theta is equal to sec 4 theta minus sec squared theta. Wow, this is amazing. Okay, so let's see from the left hand side. If I have tan 4 theta plus tan squared theta, okay, this is square theta. Now, there's a common factor. I think tan squared theta is common here. If we factorize tan squared theta, this will now become tan squared theta. Then plus, factorize tan squared theta from this is going to be 1. Okay? And that's quite easy. Now, we can substitute this. Now, your tan squared theta here is the same thing as, remember that 1 plus tan squared theta is sec squared theta. Remember, recall, 1 plus tan squared theta is equal to sec squared theta. So that means we can rewrite tan squared theta as sec squared theta minus 1, okay? So in place of tan squared theta, I can have sec squared theta minus 1. Then times tan squared theta plus 1, remember, is this, is what, sec squared theta. So in place of tan squared theta plus 1, I can introduce sec squared theta. Now we can open up the bracket. Sec squared theta times sec squared theta will give us sec 4 theta. Then minus sec squared theta times 1 will give us sec squared theta, which is exactly what we are looking for. That's exactly what we have here. This is beautiful. So you can see that if you know your identities, you're able to manipulate yourself through. Manipulate through any question. Now let's see this. We are asked to show, actually to prove that tan squared theta minus 1 over cos squared theta plus 1 is equal to 0. Wow. Okay, let's see. We have tan squared theta minus 1 over cos squared theta actually means sec squared theta. You see? Then we have plus 1. Now, if I collect like terms, or put it this way, tan squared theta, we can write this as tan squared theta plus 1 minus sec squared theta. And remember that tan squared theta plus 1 is sec squared theta. So we are going to get sec squared theta minus sec squared theta. And sec squared theta minus sec squared theta is 0. This is beautiful. Math is sweet. Math is fun. Okay, one more question here. It says, prove that sec squared theta plus cosec squared theta is equal to sec squared theta times cosec squared theta. Wow. This is really somehow. So how are we going to go about this? Now, let's start from the left-hand side. We have sec squared theta plus cosec squared theta. Now, first of all, we know that sec squared theta means 1 over cos squared theta. Let's start with that. Then plus cosec squared theta actually means 1 over sine squared theta. Let's put it that way. Okay, I think that's very straightforward. If we find the LCM now, look at this. Now the LCM is cos squared theta and sine squared theta, okay? They both are the LCM. So cosec squared theta will cancel cosec squared theta to give me this. So sine squared theta times 1 will give me sine squared theta. Then plus sine squared theta in this, we cancel this to remain cosec squared theta. Cosec squared, cos theta times 1 will give me cos theta. So if you look at the cos squared theta, the numerator sine squared theta plus cos squared theta. Remember, our identity is sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is 1. So we'll write that as 1 all over cos squared theta sine squared theta. So what is the reciprocal of cos squared theta? Is sec squared theta. Times what is the reciprocal of sine squared theta? Is cosec. So cosec squared theta, which is exactly what we are looking for. This is beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to stop here for now. We'll continue in our next class. Thank you very much.